Oi pessoal, tudo bem? Aqui é a Luciana da Street Smart Brasil. And today our lesson is about shopping vocabulary in Portuguese to help you whether you're shopping online or in person. So let's jump right into it. The first word you need to know is the verb comprar. It means to buy, to purchase, to shop. Let me say it again. Comprar. Comprar is a regular verb, so it's going to be easy to conjugate it. In fact, I have a lesson on how to conjugate verbs in general. I'll show you the logic of it and the vocabulary around it. And in that lesson, I use the present tense of regular verbs as an example. I'll put a link to the lesson in the video description. We can also say fazer compras. It also means to shop. Fazer compras. Fazer is an irregular verb, so it's easy to use it in the future tense. Let me show you. Vou fazer compras amanhã. Vou fazer compras amanhã. I'm going shopping tomorrow. So the future tense is very easy because you can use the future tense with the verb ir and you don't have to conjugate the main verb. I have a lesson about that and I'll put a link in the video description. But if you're using the verb fazer in other tenses, then you really need to learn its conjugation. For instance, this is a sentence in the past tense. Eu fiz compras ontem. Eu fiz compras ontem. I shopped yesterday. We also say fazer supermercado, to grocery shop or to go grocery shopping. Fazer supermercado. And we have this funny habit of saying fazer and using the name of the store. So Bom Preço is a very common grocery store in Recife, where I grew up. And my mom always said, vou fazer Bom Preço. It means I'm going grocery shopping and I'm going to do that at Bom Preço. So this would be like saying in English, I'm gonna hit Target today. I'm gonna hit Costco. And we Brazilians living in the US will say, eu vou fazer Target, eu vou fazer Costco. It's just, it's an idiomatic use of fazer compras. So we can comprar or fazer compras, right? To buy, to purchase, online ou pela internet. Comprar online ou comprar pela internet. Another way to talk about it when you're buying online is to say that, to order online. And we say pedir online. Pedir online. So then, o pedido is the order. Pedido. It's actually the same word you use at a restaurant. To order, you can say pedir, the verb pedir, so you would have to learn the conjugation of pedir. Or you can say fazer o pedido. Fazer o pedido. And here's an example. So imagine that you meet friends at a restaurant, and when you get there, they are already having drinks or something. You wanna ask, have you ordered? You can say, já pediram? Já pediram? Or you can say, já fizeram o pedido? Já fizeram o pedido? So we talked about ordering online, but you can also comprar em pessoa, right? You can buy in person or fazer compras em pessoa or pessoalmente. Fazer compras pessoalmente. And either way, either online or in person, you have your shopping cart, o carrinho de compras. Remember that the double R in Portuguese sounds like the H in English. Carrinho, o carrinho de compras. Hey, I would like to ask you to subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet, and please like the lesson. Feel free to ask questions, I always answer questions. When you go to the grocery store, you also have the shopping basket, a cesta de compras. A cesta de compras. And it's very common for us women to say cestinha. Cestinha. I asked my brother in Brazil if he says cesta or cestinha, and he texted me back and said, cesta, né? I'm a man. He was kidding, but it's kind of true. I think we women use the diminutive much more often than men. To push the cart, we say empurrar o carrinho. Empurrar o carrinho. And to carry the basket, carregar ou levar a cesta. You can use either verb, carregar a cesta, levar a cesta. So a common phrase is Deixa que eu levo a cesta. Leave it to me to carry the basket. Deixa que eu levo a cesta. To put something in the cart or in the basket is colocar. Colocar algo no carrinho, colocar algo na cesta. When you shop online, it's common to see adicionar ao carrinho. To add to your cart. Adicionar ao carrinho. When we shop online, we always worry about delivery time. O prazo para entrega. Prazo para entrega. Or another thing you can see is the delivery date. A data de entrega. Data de entrega. When we shop online, we also worry about the shipping cost. So what you want to know is o valor do frete. Or o preço do frete. When you're shopping in person and you go pay, you have the cash register, a caixa registradora. A caixa registradora. And in this case, I'm talking about the machine, not the person. But the person, the cashier, is also called caixa. If it's a woman, a caixa. If it's a man, o caixa. A fila, the line. A fila. Common ways to talk about a fila is to say a fila tá grande, and I'm using tá because that's how we speak, right? In everyday Brazilian life. A fila tá grande, it's big. A fila tá longa, it's long. A fila tá enorme, huge. So these are just common vocabulary that we use with line. So if I'm shopping with my friend or my husband, I can say, okay, let's go pay. Let's go to the cashier, is how we say in Portuguese. Vamos para o caixa. Vamos para o caixa. Or I can say, I'll get in line. Vou entrar na fila. Vou entrar na fila. I am in line. Estou na fila. Estou na fila. And that thing that upsets everyone, right? To cut in line. Furar a fila. Furar a fila. So I could tell someone, não fure a fila. Don't cut in line. Não fure a fila. To check out is fechar o pedido. So it's very common to see that when you're shopping online, right? You have a little button that you click and it says fechar o pedido. But also in person, the cashier may ask to fechar o pedido. If they can fechar o pedido, means are you ready? Or do you want to add anything else here? Or can I finish your checkout? When we buy in person, we can use cash. Pagar em dinheiro. Pagar em dinheiro. And in Brazil, it's a very good idea to always carry change. That's dinheiro trocado. So I recommend that you carry dinheiro trocado with you in Brazil, because it's very common for people to not have change for you. Now, here's an interesting thing. The change that you get when you pay for something, like something costs $18.85 and you pay with a 20, the change that you get back is troco, troco. So in English, it's the same word, change, right? But in Portuguese, you have trocado, which is the change, as in the money in small denominations that you carry with you. And you have troco, which is change, as in money returned when a payment exceeds the amount due. You can also pay with a card, pagar com cartão, cartão. And when you're shopping in person, it's very common for the cashier to ask debit or credit when you give your card. Débito ou crédito? Débito ou crédito? Another very common question in Brazil is, vai parcelar? Are you going to pay installments? And this is because in Brazil, when you have a Brazilian credit card, I should say this is not going to work with your international credit card unless your country does the same thing. But in Brazil, when you pay with a credit card, basically anywhere you go, any store will allow you to pay in a certain number of installments without paying any interest. So say I go grocery shopping and it comes out to, I don't know, R$250. They will ask if I want to pay in installments. And oftentimes they say you can pay in up to 3 installments. This amount can be paid in up to 12 installments. Especially if you're buying household items like appliances or things that are more expensive, you can always pay in up to 12 installments without any interest, sometimes even more. So in your credit card statement, say you bought something that's R$1,000. and you chose to pay it in 10 installments. So each one of the next 10 statements of your credit card will come with 100 reais for that purchase, and it will indicate installment 1 of 10, installment 2 of 10. So here's an example of a cashier telling you you can pay it in up to 12 installments. Pode parcelar em até 12 vezes. Pode parcelar em até 12 vezes. If you need to gift wrap something, you can say é para presente. Or you can say é presente. It's a gift. To gift wrap is embrulhar para presente. Embrulhar para presente. Another verb you can use is embalar. Embalar para presente. Embalar para presente. So if you go to a store, you can ask, can you gift wrap it? Pode embrulhar para presente? Or pode embalar para presente? Okay, to exchange something, like you got a t-shirt, it's too large, you want to exchange it. Trocar. Trocar. So you need to know the exchange policy of the store. Política de trocas. Política de trocas. Let me tell you, in Brazil, it's not as simple and as easy as it is in the US. So it's a good idea to know the política de trocas of the store. To return, devolver. Devolver. And the return policy, política de devolução. Política de devolução. The exchange or return deadline, or how long you have to return or exchange, é o prazo para troca e devolução. Prazo para troca e devolução. And the refund is reembolso. You need to say the two E's here. Reembolso. Reembolso. Now, again, in Brazil, it's not as easy as it is in the US. And it's actually rare for stores to give you a refund, to accept returns and give you a refund. Most of them will exchange the item for you, but sometimes you need to give ID and you need to give CPF, which is our individual taxpayer number, and there's a very limited timeline in which you can do that. It can be a little frustrating, I'll have to say that. Okay, I hope this lesson will help you shop in Brazil or at a Brazilian shop anywhere in the world. Street Smart Brazil offers Portuguese lessons via video meetings. We've been doing that since 2008. This is our expertise. We have a lot of experience helping learners around the globe speak Portuguese. And with one-on-one lessons, you can learn at your pace. You learn what you want, and you control your schedule. To book a trial lesson with us, visit my website, streetsmartbrazil.com. I will put a link in the video description. Muito obrigada. Tchau, tchau.